Now we have the third method, that is our expenditure method. I told you, na, second method is the earning method, how we earn. This is how we dispose our income. So the third method is the expenditure method, and in the beginning again you recall where we spend. Your parents are sending you here for classes. You spend your money on books, on school fee, on tuition fee, and many more. So this is what we are spending on GDP at MP. So all components of expenditure method will give you the value of GDP at MP. Now, how do we spend? Our third method is expenditure method. In expenditure method, we have private final consumption expenditure. It is the expenditure of households plus non-profit institutions. Then government final consumption expenditure. Government is also spending on GDP, like government purchase cement, raw material, everything. So government is producer also as well as consumer also. Then we have gross domestic fixed capital formation. It means we are investing on fixed assets, building, plant, machinery, equipment, residential construction, purchase of plot, land, anything. So this is fixed. If it is fixed, you have to take change in stock, that is your inventory. If you are holding or stocking any inventory, that is also the part of capital formation. So both these together will give you the value of gross domestic capital formation, gross investment, or gross capital formation. Don't get confused. Simple hai, agar fixed hai, you have to take change in stock. If there is no fix, it is inclusive of change in stock. We do spend, na? We have to have our expenditure on retaining stock of raw material, semi-finished good, livestock, and at the last we have net exports. Net export is export minus import. Very small method. So, if we add all this, we will get the value of GDP at MP, because we all spend on GDP at MP only. If I will take an example of household, household is consuming milk, purchasing bread, paying school fee, tuition fee. So, we have government final consumption expenditure, government is purchasing raw material. Government is also purchasing various goods and services. You take an example of government department. For running and functioning of government department, government is also purchasing from different sectors of an economy. Then we have capital formation. If it is fixed, then you have to take change in stock separately. Now, what is gross domestic capital formation? I'll give you at the end what are the components also, but I hope this is clear to you how to reach GDP at MP, because now after coming to this method, now it is very easy for you how to go to NNP at FC if GDP at MP is given. GDP at MP mein se simple, depreciation hataya, net ban gaya, NIT hataya, FC ban gaya, NFIA add kiya, national ban gaya. So we have NNP at FC is nothing but national income. अगर डोमेस्टिक इनकम में रहना है वी ओनली डिडक्ट डेप्रिसिएशन एंड एनआईटी. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू. आई गिव यू सम टिप्स रिलेटेड टू दिस मेथड दैट यू हैव टू कीप इन योर माइंड. ऑल्दो वी डिड इन द बिगिनिंग दैट प्रैक्टिस इन द फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्टरी सेशन अबाउट नेशनल इनकम अकाउंटिंग, इफ इट इज जी डी पी एट एम पी, दिस इज द फर्स्ट हिंट फॉर यू. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेक इट नेट, डिडक्ट डेप्रिसिएशन. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेक नेट ग्रॉस, एड डेप्रिसिएशन. सिमिलरली मार्केट में है, वी वॉन्ट टू गो टू फैक्टर कॉस्ट लेस एनआईटी. अगर मार्केट से फैक्ट्री से मार्केट में जाना है, फैक्टर कॉस्ट मीन्स फैक्ट्री. फैक्टर कॉस्ट मीन्स द कॉस्ट विच कॉन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ फैक्टर इनपुट, फैक्टर ओनर्स, लैंड, लेबर, कैपिटल, एंटरप्रीन्योर, दैट इज योर प्राइमरी इनपुट्स. सो यू विल एड एनआईटी. सो ग्रॉस इज नेट, दिस इज डिडक्ट डेप्रिसिएशन. मार्केट प्राइस फैक्टर कॉस्ट, इट बिकम्स नेट डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट एट फैक्टर कॉस्ट, इट इज डोमेस्टिक इनकम. एनडीपी एट एफ सी इज डोमेस्टिक इनकम. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू मेक दिस डोमेस्टिक इन टू नेशनल, आई जस्ट एड एन एफ आई ए, दिस विल बिकम नेशनल. वी डिड दिस प्रैक्टिस इन द फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्टरी सेशन ऑफ नेशनल इनकम, द सेम आई एम अप्लाइंग हियर ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज one thing you have to keep in your mind while dealing with this production method, expenditure method. The last thing I want to give you, because somewhere in numericals you have to have this confusion shape is given to you, that how to deal with this particular component. I told you gross domestic capital formation is a sum of gross domestic fixed capital formation plus change in stock. This gross domestic capital formation is also known as gross investment or gross capital formation. And for hint, if you want to take कि कैसे डील करना है, अगर फिक्स दिया हुआ है तो यू हैव टू टेक चेंज इन स्टॉक. इफ फिक्स इज नॉट गिवन, इट मींस इट इज ग्रॉस डोमेस्टिक कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन. नाउ व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ ग्रॉस डोमेस्टिक कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन? इट कंप्राइजेज ऑफ ग्रॉस इन्वेंट्री इन्वेस्टमेंट, gross public investment. Public means government investment, construction of road, dams, buildings. Gross residential construction investment. Here construction doesn't mean ki aapne ek balcony ko extend kar diya ghar mein, major construction which has increases the value of your house or flat or anything, land. And the last is gross business investment, business fixed investment, like purchase of machinery, plant, building, fixtures. So this is only the important thing in this method. If you are very clear with this component, you are able to do any type of numerical based on expenditure method. I just recall you this method: private final consumption expenditure, government final consumption expenditure, gross domestic fixed capital formation, if it is fixed, change in stock, plus net exports. This will give you the value of GDP at MP. And when you deduct depreciation, you will get NDP at MP. If you deduct NIT, net indirect taxes, you will get NDP at FC. So, NDP at FC is your domestic income, and when you add NFIA, it would be your national income, that is NNP at FC. So, this is the third method of estimating national income. And for numerical purpose, there is a question based on income and expenditure method simultaneously. We will discuss that also in a new session, how to deal with the numerical which is based on income and expenditure method. But for that, you have to be very, very clear about the income and expenditure method. Thank you. So, the second method of estimating national income is income method. Income now, this method is again in the beginning I told you is very important because this talk about how the factor owners earn their income in lieu of their productive factor services. Now, again in this method also we have domestic income, national income, but this is from earning point of view, how we earn because of our productive factor services. Now, here I want to tell you in the beginning again before we switch over to table, the table means the easiest way of learning and understanding your things and then application based also. We have domestic income. Domestic income is NDP at FC. So, this domestic income is sum of our economy is mixed economy. So, domestic income is sum of income from domestic product or NDP at FC accruing to private sector, and same here, income from domestic product or NDP at FC accruing to government sector. I hope I am clearer to you because our economy is a mixed economy. So, mixed economy, we talk about the income generation from both the sectors. Here, I want to say one more thing. This is known as government surplus. This is known as government surplus. It comprises of, you know, government surplus. We have income from property. Property and entrepreneurship accruing to government administrative department and savings of non-department. Now, what is government administrative department? If you had been to airport, what is there on airport? Airport is only one, but different airline services are there. and they pay in crores to Airport Authority of India for using their airport property. Then government is a very good entrepreneur, Indian Railways. So Railway Department, we have income from property and entrepreneurship. Then we have non-departmental. Non-departmental, like we have LIC. So government surplus and private sector. We have income from property and income from domestic product, that is NDP at FC, accruing to private sector and government sector. This will make our domestic income. So this is what the domestic income is, from private sector and from government sector. Now we will discuss the components of both private and government sector. I hope it is clear to you. So we switch over to the next part, the same table part. We have first government surplus. Now in private sector, how do people earn? People have rent, they earn rent royalty, then interest. There are people who earn interest also, a very good income. Then we have profit. Now here we talk about profit is divided into UP, CT and dividend. Again, recall the beginning lesson introduction. UP is undistributed profit. It is also known as savings of private corporate. It is also known as reserves. It is also known as flowing back of profit. Corporate tax, that is your out of profit, every corporate has to pay a direct tax. Then dividend, shareholder's income is known as dividend. And UP, CT and dividend is your profit. This we did all in the beginning of the introduction. And rent, interest, profit is known as operating surplus. Then how people earn? People will earn compensation of employees, cash, kind, social security benefit and retirement pension. Then people have mixed income. So this is what the domestic income. This is your domestic income, NDP at FC. Now, in domestic income, if I add NFIA, it becomes national income, NNP at FC. I hope this is clear to you. Domestic income and national income, this is same as we did in the beginning, that domestic plus NFIA is your national income. Now here in this method, we have two more things. Now we switch over to private sector, private income. This is overall private income. I know you have this type of confusion in your mind, that in the beginning sir has told us that our income is the sum of government surplus and income from domestic product accruing to private sector. But this is overall private income. Overall means within the domestic territory and beyond the domestic territory. So in private, there is no role of government. We have rent, interest, UP, CT, dividend, compensation, mixed income, NFIA, plus all current transfers. Now, what are transfer payments? Transfer payments are those unilateral payments which are received without quid pro quo, that is without rendering any productive services. Transfer payments, scholarship, donation, national debt interest, unemployment allowances, scholarship, these are all come under the transfer payment. Here I want to add one more thing. There is a difference between domestic income, national income and private income. Domestic and national income, they only talk about earned income, no unearned income. Whereas private, and then we switch over to personal income. In personal income also, we talk about unearned income. Unearned income is transfer payment. Earned income is rent, interest, profit, compensation. Now, when we switch over to personal income comprises of, I hope I am visible to you, personally means suppose I am a person, I am a worker, I am an employee, what I receive, what I earn, maybe I earn rent, interest, UP is reserved by company, UP is undistributed, not distributed, therefore it is not distributed and we are not calculating it. CT, it goes to government, dividend, compensation, mixed income, NFIA and all transfers. This is your personal income. Personal income means income of a particular household. So, this is what the complete picture of your income method. See, with this table, you are able to solve, I am damn sure you are able to solve any type of numerical. I am also adding one more part which is left at the end because I am taking, because this is full now, I am just going to rub it. I hope it is clear to you. All of you have jotted down this. Now I am coming to, I will again repeat the same, but this is the conclusion of this method, income method. We discuss, there are so many things. When we discuss numericals, then more things will come to your conclusion, means you are able to understand it. So, what we did in the beginning, we have domestic income, NDP at FC, domestic income, what we did, we have added NFIA. We got national income, NNP at FC, then we have deducted government surplus. Please refer to your table, the previous table, government surplus, and add all transfers, all current transfers. You have private income less UPCT because UP is reserved and CT is for government tax. We have personal income. This is the short snap of your whole table. Now, at the end, when you have personal income, what we do? We do pay direct taxes. We do pay personal direct taxes. We have many payment to government, so miscellaneous government receipt like your school, college fee, your passport fee, your license fee. The remaining income is your disposable income. Disposable income. Obviously, we have to have the tax. If our income is high, if we are exempted, we need not to pay, but then also we have to pay some government receipts. This disposable income, this is tax free income, it is on my wish only what to do with this income, but majorly I will do personal consumption expenditure and I save also. So, personal consumption expenditure, or you call it as a personal final consumption expenditure and savings. So, this is what the income method. We have started from domestic income and we have concluded with personal disposable income. I hope with this it is very clear to you. It is very easy for you to do any type of numerical if the table, if the concepts are clear to you.
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें, अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं, क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से, जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए।
NIOS देता रहा है युवाओं को अवसर आगे बढ़ने का। NIOS से पढ़ने वाले इन युवाओं ने किया है संस्थान को गौरवान्वित। दिव्यांगों ने बनके दिखाया है सबल और आत्मनिर्भर NIOS के साथ। आप भी जुड़िए NIOS के संग।